In today's video, I'm going to share tips to get around three common barriers to preparing more meals at home. Hi, my name is Mary Johnson. I'm a registered dietitian and owner of Healing Food for Cancer. In my practice, I recommend for most people, not everyone, but for most people that they follow an anti-inflammatory diet. And I will drop links to a couple of videos that I've done on the anti-inflammatory diet in the description below. The first barrier that I hear a lot about is a lack of time. And my first tip is don't go to the grocery store yourself. Buy your groceries online and have them delivered. Have somebody else spend the time walking up and down the aisles, picking things out, and then bringing it to you. It is a beautiful thing to open your door and to have all of the groceries that you've ordered just sitting there waiting for you. I am a big fan of, I have access to both Whole Foods and Amazon Prime groceries, and they keep track of all of my past purchases, so it is extremely easy for me to just go through and click on the items that I have ordered before that I'd like to purchase again, so that all the brands and the sizes and the common fruits and vegetables that I order are all right there, and I can place an order at a fraction of the time, much quicker than what I could actually go and get at the grocery store. And if you have Amazon Prime, it is free. But that can easily afford you some additional time. So if you have someone deliver the groceries to you and spend their time, it means that you've freed up at a minimum probably an hour that you can spend meal prepping. So have them do the shopping and you spend your precious time doing the prepping. So that's tip number one. So my next tip both addresses the time constraint as well as the very common concern that I hear around people saying they just don't know how to cook. They didn't grow up in a family that did a whole lot of cooking. Maybe they relied on convenience foods or eating out a lot, and it's just not something that they feel super comfortable with. So my next tip is to meal prep, and that helps if you spend a couple of hours. Again, if you've had somebody do your grocery shopping, that can free up at least an hour for you. And if you've done meal prep over the weekend, it means that during the week, it'll be much easier to either have something ready to go or some simple additional assembly that will only take you a few minutes before you can enjoy a delicious meal. And you can prepare your breakfast and your lunch as well, so that you just really don't have to think about what you're going to eat throughout the week. It's all planned out for you. I recommend a cookbook that I really like for an anti-inflammatory diet that is for meal prepping. It's the Anti-Inflammatory Diet Meal Prep Cookbook. And I will also drop a link to purchase the cookbook in the description below. I have recommended this cookbook to clients, and I've gotten feedback that the recipes are easy to prepare, that the directions for preparing them are excellent, that they aren't overcomplicated, and that things turn out exactly as they're described, and that they find all of the recipes to be delicious. And I would agree, having cooked my way through this cookbook, probably about 80% through the cookbook, I would absolutely agree with that. I have a lot of new favorite recipes that I have found. So I would strongly recommend doing meal prep and finding a cookbook, whether it's this one or another one, that has really good instructions about how to go about the preparation of the recipes. And it may take you a little time, as I say, up front to prepare the meals, but what you'll find is it'll save you loads of time during the week if you can go to your fridge and pull out items that are, again, almost done or all prepared, and all you may need to do is heat it and then enjoy a beautifully prepared home-cooked meal that you know exactly what it contains. My third tip might seem like it's not that big of a deal, but trust me, it is. It's having proper storage containers to store your food in after you've done the meal prep. So if you have spent the time to prepare a beautiful meal, you need to be sure that it's going to be easy to organize in your either your fridge or your freezer, that it's going to be easy to transport, and that it's not going to go bad. So I really like glass containers, and I keep, as you can see, a variety of sizes around, different shapes as well, some round, some square. All of these have a plastic lid that snaps on and off very easily, and they are very durable. I can't tell you how many times I have accidentally had one of these drop on the floor, and I'm sure if you threw them on the floor, you could break them, but they've fallen out of the fridge and they haven't broken. And I've carried them back and forth to work and they have held up just beautifully. The other thing that I recommend is that you can write with a Sharpie what it is and the date that you made it. And my experience has been that when I put my dishes in the dishwasher, it just washes right off. So if you know exactly what it is, even if you put something in the freezer a few months back, you can go back and see exactly what it is and what the date is that you prepared it. It really helps to have glass containers in a variety of sizes, helps with organization, and it's just so much more appealing if you have done your prep to have everything nicely organized and easy to retrieve from the fridge. I hope this video has been helpful. As always, these videos are not intended to be a substitute for one-on-one individualized care. If you'd like to learn more about working with me one-on-one, you can visit my website at healingfoodforcancer.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.